Hey all, and welcome to our video. So today we're looking at Hikvision's Intercom, and we're still on our Villa series, and we'll be adding a Wi-Fi screen to an existing setup. Okay guys, so we just got a one door station, one screen, and we're going to add a second one through Wi-Fi. So that means you don't have to hardwire into your switch. You can power it locally, do the cable it comes with. Oops, it comes through a cable, and you're going to need a female power jack to, and a power supply in order to power your screen. So once you've got that together, and we go to the back of it, the unit, and just connect that in, and the unit will start powering up. Okay, so obviously our existing system is hardwired in. So let me show you that in action. Okay, so that's the system working, and now we're going to do it so the second screen will work. All right, guys, but I do give you guys a bit of a note that when you are using Wi-Fi, I mean, the results are not as good as you have it hardwired. So guys, always try and run a cable if you can, and I would say only use the Wi-Fi if you have no other option. Okay, so just a second now and the screen will load up. Okay, so zoom in on the screen. All right, so enter the same password as you use for your existing system. Okay, we don't need emails authentication. That's if you're forget your password. Okay, all you have to do is on the wizard enter the registration password. I use the same password as always, and then versus the wizard we could just go next, because this is all for basically hardwired systems. Okay, all right, so now first thing is we need to connect to our Wi-Fi. So we go settings and then go to Wi-Fi, turn the Wi-Fi on, and then you'll see you'll have a list of your Wi-Fi, and then find your Wi-Fi and enter in the password. Okay, so once you've entered the password in, then you go okay, and you will see it will connect. Okay, connecting, connected. Okay, now we go back. Now we have to go to our configuration. Okay. Right, and as you see, we're straight in the first panel in configuration. You've got indoor station type. Okay, now it's not an indoor station technically; it is a indoor extension. Okay, so we make it indoor extension. All right, guys. So then we go back to the configuration panel. Now you need to know the IP of your screen. If you've only got one screen on the system, you should be easy to find. Okay. So we go extension, we've already done that bit. Now we go down to, okay, device management here. Under the clipboard looking icon, you see indoor station hasn't got an IP address. We click on here. Now it's going to find the main station, and I know it's this one here, okay? Because we've got a couple of different systems here at the workplace. All right, but now we've selected it, we go back. As you see here, now the main indoor station has got an IP address, perfect. That's all we've got to do, guys. All right, so this should be working now. Let's bring up the other screen. As you see, it's synced the times automatically. Okay, so the extension screen will take all its information off the main screen. All right, so if you've added IP cameras, all that stuff, it's all gonna take the information. So now we'll ring it and hopefully both screens should ring. Okay, there we go, guys. So let's start to add the extension screen through the Wi-Fi. As you saw, there was a little error code on the Wi-Fi screen. I mean, sometimes the picture can be black, but that I think that's the Wi-Fi issue, guys. But you know, like I said earlier, hardwired is always the way to go. But anyway, thanks for watching. So hopefully now you can add a screen to your existing system, or you can start a new system and then have two screens or more. So if you do this, you can repeat this process again and again and again, and you can have more extensions. So thanks for watching. More to come on this series, so stay tuned. But hopefully catch you later, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.